opening scene, Megadeth's Dave Mustaine has been an instrumental part of the music industry for decades now. He was attracted to metal music as a teenager and was keen to play the guitar. According to AllMusic, he eventually managed to teach himself and delve deeper into the world of music, paying attention to popular bands at the time such as Venom and Iron Maiden. One of his most memorable songs is Jump in the Fire, a track that he came up with for Metallica. Mustaine told the Rolling Stone, "I was writing about myself being young and sitting in my room and feeling dejected. I had my head in my hands and didn't know what to do." He added that at that age, he was really lonely and felt like he could only be himself with his friends. This is tragic details about Dave Mustaine. His childhood was difficult. For Dave Mustaine, his early years were incredibly traumatic. He was born in La Mesa, California in September 1961. It was really difficult for Mustaine and his family to have a peaceful environment at home on account of his dad. He was addicted to alcohol and would not hesitate to get violent with those around him. As a result, they kept moving to different places to avoid him. Mustaine's mom was very strict and religious, which made him feel quite restricted at home. Talking about his childhood, he remarked, "My dad drank a lot and was abusive, so my parents got divorced when I was young and it got worse from there." They stayed in Costa Mesa with his aunt, who was also deeply religious and a Jehovah's Witness. This in turn influenced his mom and motivated her to become a Jehovah's Witness as well. Mustaine resented living like that. He said, "My life was ruined from that point onwards until I moved out." Lost his band members. Dave Mustaine was drawn to music as a child. According to a piece by Guitar World, it started with a funny story. His sister was trying to get better at playing the piano, but she wasn't very skilled. He started practicing the guitar just to drown her out. He had a generous brother-in-law back then who lent his guitar to Mustaine. After that, there was no looking back. He had found something he really liked doing. However, Mustaine didn't have it easy. For one, he couldn't afford expensive equipment, and his first guitar was a simple piece that cost him $80. He also formed a music group called Panic, but he didn't realize that would mean he'd get a taste of tragedy early on when he lost three band members in two different terrible accidents. Describing the incidents, Mustaine said that the first accident occurred after a party. "I stayed behind and these two guys went home. They were driving down the Pacific Coast Highway, south of the pier by the Jack in the Box, and crashed." He added, "Panic had a very painful beginning. Our other guitar player also died in a car crash. It was kind of a very painful dark period when I started playing." Was let go from Metallica. Dave Mustaine was forced to endure a professional heartbreak early in his career. According to Loudwire, in 1983, Mustaine received shocking news. He had been replaced by guitarist Kirk Hammett as a part of Metallica. Mustaine was gutted. He said, "The thing that really upset me was that they never gave me a warning, and I never got a second chance. It was just, hey man, you're out, see you later." On the bus ride back home, the musician decided to express his feelings by writing a song. He didn't know it back then, but this would inspire him to form his popular metal band Megadeth. Because he didn't have any writing tools on him, Mustaine used a flyer from Senator Alan Cranston. It had a message on the front which read, "The arsenal of Megadeth can't be rid." This is how he came up with a name for his next band. Also, Mustaine's only complaint was that he should have at least received some kind of warning from Metallica before he was ousted from the group. He knew he was a reckless band member and was irresponsible, which is what ultimately led to his exit. He was filled with self-doubt. Dave Mustaine couldn't help but reflect on his future after he was fired from Metallica. The bus that would take him home gave him a lot of time to think about his next steps. He said, "I did a lot of soul searching on the way home. Did I want to play guitar? Did I want to keep doing this? What am I gonna do?" Despite feeling confused about everything, he felt that he could perhaps form a band of his own, something that would essentially set him free from Metallica. Through the years, Mustaine tried to step out of his comfort zone whenever he could, as a performer, for example. When he tried a wah-wah pedal for the first time, he was unsure about the results but gave it a shot anyway. He posted a video on Instagram before his performance and said, "I don't know how it's gonna turn out, so if you're here, you'll find out. If you're not, check back later and see, but I'm really excited about it." dealt with addiction. For Dave Mustaine, one of his toughest struggles was confronting his substance abuse. Per the Baltimore Sun, when he was caught by cops, Mustaine had 9 different chemicals in his body. He said that at first he was hooked on alcohol and pot, but as time went by, he found himself reaching out for other options such as cocaine and heroin. In the ensuing chaos, Mustaine's career took a backseat. His environment didn't do him any favors either. Mustaine said that one of his ex-managers would keep sending his band plenty of drugs when they were touring to keep the group distracted. After Mustaine achieved sobriety in 1990, he went back to focusing on Megadeth with bassist David Ellefson. In a powerful statement, Mustaine said that it's only when you lose something that you learn to value what you have. He said it's almost like you need to have that carrot taken away from you for you to appreciate it. I had it when I was with Metallica in 1983 and lost it. I had it when I started Megadeth, and then I lost it again to drugs. An injury damaged his left arm. In 2002, Dave Mustaine suffered a severe injury that made him wonder whether he'd ever be able to play music again. According to Billboard, the musician made the decision to put an end to Megadeth at that point. It was said that Mustaine had suffered severe nerve damage and doctors told him that he had a compressed radial nerve. He added that he would need at least 1 whole year to recover, and it was impossible to tell whether he'd be fit enough to play. Mustaine had not given up hope. He mentioned that he was determined to work hard with his doctors and physical therapists to get back to playing once again. He also said, "For the time being, I have decided to exit Megadeth and explore other areas of the music business where I might make a contribution without being able to play my instrument." It was later revealed that Mustaine got injured when he was asleep on a chair. His arm was awkwardly positioned, which led to the injury. He somehow got back on track and made a comeback in 2004, after taking a break for 18 months. Feels like the public doesn't know him. As a musician and as an individual, Dave Mustaine knows that he doesn't appeal to everyone. He told Kerrang that he isn't perceived correctly. "People don't know me at all, they think they do, but they only know the guy Lars Ulrich and James Hetfield have been trying to smear for 40 years, referring to his former band members from Metallica. He further stated that the audience knows the person who reacts to these comments, but not him. Mustaine also went on to say that he usually doesn't say much unless he's provoked. He added, "If someone said something I didn't like, I may have retaliated in jest, but never seriously. I would never attack anyone without good reason." In the same interview, the musician spoke about some of his early struggles, such as the fact that one of his former managers wasn't legitimate and was, in fact, a drug dealer who stole a major chunk of their money and made life really hard for them. Had a huge conflict with Nick Menza. Megadeth's ex-drummer Nick Menza died unexpectedly in 2016 after he suffered a heart attack. He'd been a part of Megadeth from the late 1980s till 1998. According to the BBC, the tragedy occurred when Menza was playing a gig in Los Angeles with his band. His death was shocking to his friends, and his biographer said at the time that they were all too numb to think about anything but Nick's family. As per Louder Sound, Nick Menza did not get along with Dave Mustaine at all. The drummer's ex-manager Robert Bolger said, "Dave wasn't very nice to Nick towards the end before his passing." Bolger added that Mustaine had made up stuff while speaking about his relationship with Menza in his book Rust in Peace. He also said that Menza's family was never included when Mustaine was working on the book, and they didn't even know that it was going to be published. Per music feeds, after Menza's death, Mustaine offered his condolences and said that he was friends with the drummer. He also said there were several times we discussed him coming back to the band, but for various reasons it never came together. "We've been in touch all along. He had come out to our shows recently, and he had remained a great friend, a true professional, and a larger-than-life personality."